Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we're going to do some advanced tracking with the new Intellitrack in the Resolve 19 studio. I have this clip of two people on bicycles here. We're going to track and put their name on both of them. I'm going to show you how to track on and off the screen and show you how fast this tracker is. We want to set it so the beginning of the bike, the front wheel, is just beyond the edge of the frame. Then we'll jump 1 second. So if you hold the shift key down, hit the arrow, it'll move 1 second. I'm on a 30 frame per second frame rate. Gotta have room for the data. And the same thing with the second biker. This media I got from Pixabay. I recommend dropping a little coin if you have it. Then we'll jump ahead 1 second there too. You can either make it a fusion clip or a compound clip. Either one will work. Put your playhead over it and go to fusion. With the media in selected, shift space and tracker. I have it typed in already. We don't already know the Intellitrack is right with the original tracker. You have both options right here. I'm going to purposely track this incorrectly, show you what will happen, and then I'll show you what I did to get around it. Under adaptive mode, go down to best match. Track forward. No matter what, when you're doing this, it's going to show bad tracking, even when we do it correctly. We lost this track because the second biker ran into it. You delete them right up here. So what I'll do is move the first biker to the end of the frame. Go back to best match. And I'll track forward. Like I said, it'll tell you it didn't render completely. We'll fix that in a little bit here. Bring the playhead back to the first track. Now we'll track backward. Just as in the original tracker, it's got the window. You want to use that to center it. Go up and open your spline. Make sure you select them. Little window up here, you can shrink it. Zoom to fit. I'm going to bring the playhead back till we have our last, in this case, this would be the first bad track. Be right there. Highlight them, right click, and delete. Now you'll see the line coming in is flat. I'm going to go to the last good track. It's right there. Now we'll delete all the tracking down come to play it. We'll give it a play and see if it goes through. Now right click in the box. Come up to gradient, extrapolation. Very hard word to say. Now I'll give it a play and you should see it come in and go all the way out. We may have to come back to this. But if you see the line in and out now has a curve to it. After we selected the gradient. Extrapolation. I'll lock them. Close the window. Now we'll track the second one. If you don't already know me, I have to use this on-screen keyboard because I'm paralyzed. Can't use my hands and arms. I put that out there every time because a few people question why I had it in the way, and that's why. Trust me, it's more annoying for me than it is you. We'll add another track. We'll lock the first one. This one will do the opposite. We'll track that one coming in. Again, under adaptive mode, best match. This time I'll track backward first. Go back to where we started. And track forward. Like I said, it says render did not complete. Go back up and open your spline. Zoom to fit. Put your playhead as the first good track. We'll delete all them. Now we'll take it to the last good track. And then right click in the box. And gradient, extrapolation again. If you look at your in and your out, it has a curve now. With the tracker node selected, we'll get two merge. We'll grab two text plus. And we'll give it a name. And we'll select the merge one. Go up here to center, right click. Connect two. Tracker path one. Position. Automatically put the name above the first character. I'm going to adjust it up a little bit, so select the text node. Go to layout, center Y. Give it a play and see if it's coming in and out okay. Kind of leading. We're going to go back and take another track out. It's completely leaving the screen. That's all I did this tutorial. and to show how fast this tracker actually is. The original tracker can no way keep up with it. Take one more. That looks good now. Connect the second text box. Again, select Merge 2 this time. Right click on Center. Connect 2. Tracker Path 2. Position. We'll select the text node and raise it up. Under Layout. Center Y. So we're losing our track here a little bit. Select the tracker node again. And we'll select the second one. And let's take out two more. Looks good now. And we can lock that one so we don't lose it. Give it a play. We can also add some blur to it. Shift space. And directional blur. Copy. Click away, right click, and paste instance. Connect them like that. For those of you that don't know what an instance is, it's an exact copy of whatever node you're taking it off from. In the inspector, everything highlighted in green indicates that it's still coupled to the original node. You can de-instance some things. We're not going to do that here. You can do the adjustment in either one. I'm just going to put a little bit at 0.008. That'll adjust them both at the same time. Well, there you go. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one.